Eu estou chorando. Hello guys. How can I see the chatting window? Oh, I don't know. Can you hear me, guys? Oh, okay. Oh, okay. I now I found the chatting window here. Oh, sorry. Okay. Yeah, thank you. Okay, guys. Welcome to this course, the computer architecture course for undergraduate student. And my name is Geukhan Ku. I'm an instructor of this course. And due to the COVID-19 pandemic, so I need to provide this course on the online as the online course, and then. Actually, I'm using the Zoom for the first time. So actually, in the previous semester, I recorded my lecture video and then I uploaded the recorded video on the YouTube. But this semester, the university recommend real-time streaming class. So this semester, I try to use real-time streaming class for the first time. I think it's not an easy time for students, also for me, because of the COVID-19 pandemic. But it's also a new challenge for everyone, actually for us. So university also tried some new attempt and then tried some new type of classes to students. Also, the instructors are provide some new types of classes. So it may not be easy for everyone, but study hard and then try do your best for this course. Okay. So in this time I will briefly introduce about this course. So okay, let's talk about the object of this course. Object of this course is exploring computer system architecture at an abstract level. And then please focus on the word abstract. And this abstract word is very important to the computer engineering or computer science students. What is the meaning of abstract? So, yeah, because this is the online course, it's not easy to interact with students. I know. So the meaning of abstract is the in Korean is a 추상화, and then so actually the abstract means that it hides some difficult thing or hide some details that is not required to understand. So the object of this course is to understand the computer system architecture at an abstract level. So actually the computer hardware or computer system is a complex system, it's a complicated system. So it's not easy to understand the entire scope of this computer hardware or computer systems, actually including the software. So not to understand this computer system, we hide some details that is difficult to understand. So we hide these details, but we try to understand some core things of the computer system. So in this course, so we are learning about the computer system architecture, so computer hardware, and then some interface between hardware and software at an abstract level, not every detail. And then I will explain the meaning of the abstract later. Actually, I just showed some object of this course, okay? Yeah. Okay. So what will be covered in this course? So in this course, we will learn about the basic concept of computer systems. And then in detail, we will learn about the performance metric. So what is the performance metric? Actually, performance metric is some criteria to determine some performance of the computer system. So I will explain later, but the purpose of the computer architecture research is to improve the performance of computer systems. But how can we know which computer is better, which idea is better for the computers? So we need to know about the performance metrics. And then we will learn about the instruction set architecture, called the ISA and machine language. So did you hear about, heard about the x86 or ARM architecture? Where is the chatting window? Where is the chatting window? Yeah, it's not easy, it's easy to interact. Yeah, so I believe someone have heard about the x86 architecture or ARM architecture. That means the instruction set architecture. So instruction set architecture determines some instructions that is executed in the computer hardware. And then also this instruction set architecture decides some hardware behavior by instructions. So actually if we determine the instruction set architecture, then it sets some behavior of computer hardware by instruction. So actually when we talk about the computer architecture, originally, that means the instruction set architecture. Okay, and then so we will cover arithmetic logic and then number systems. But I believe computer engineering student already took the, I believe, computer engineering student took the digital logic design course, then this arithmetic logic and the number system of the computer hardware was already covered in the digital system logic course. So in this course, I will cover this arithmetic logic and the number system very quickly. Okay, and then I will cover in-order processor architecture. It's a pipelining architecture. This pipelining architecture is a very important topic in this course. So if you take this course, then you need to understand what is pipelining and then why pipelining is good, and then what is the issue in the pipelining. It's a very important topic. Also, pipelining is the important topic in the digital system design. Actually, every digital system deploy the pipelining architecture. Okay. Also, another important topic in this course is memory hierarchy. Also, this memory hierarchy is called the memory systems. So why memory systems are very important in the computer system? Actually, all user data is stored in the memory system. So what is the memory system? It's the memory in the computer processors like the CPU, also the external memory such as DRAM. Also DRAM is called the main memory. Also the storage system like HDD or SSD. Those are all memory systems. They're called the memory systems or memory hierarchy. So actually all your data and my data are stored in the memory systems. And then for the computer, when the computer executes some instructions, computer requires the data. And then data is stored in the memory system. So actually the stored data should be transferred to the computer processor, right? And then this data should be ready in the computer processor to execute some instructions. So that's why the memory system is important in the computer system. So actually, mainly there are three important topics in this course: the instruction set architecture, pipelining, and memory hierarchy. And then finally, we will learn about the parallel processor architecture. So actually, the most of the modern processor is the multi-core processor. And the multi-core processor is deployed to improve the performance of a computer system. So parallel processor architecture is also a very important topic, but it's an advanced topic. So for the undergraduate student course, the parallel processor is not covered in detail. So it will be covered in the advanced computer architecture course, okay? Do you have any questions? I'll chat here. Pipelining. Yeah, you will learn about the pipelining later. So pipelining in analogy, pipelining is some conveyor belt. What is the conveyor belt in the factory? So in the factory, there are many steps, and then conveyor belt starts from the person one to the person two and person three, and then the different people, different person, do some different job. So pipelining is very similar to this conveyor belt in the factory. So pipelining is just a step, right? And then this different step, in the different step, computer does different jobs, like some instruction fetch or instruction decoding or execution. So at every step, instructions are executed, and then some part of job of instruction is performed at every step. You know, so I briefly explained, but you will learn about the pipeline in more detail in the chapter 4. Okay. Any other questions? Okay. 네, 그래도 뭐 네, 질문도 하고 좋네요. 인터랙션이 좀 있네요. 네, 제가 뭐 영어로 질문한 학생이 네, 저 if you wanna So actually, you can ask question in Korean or in English. Even though this is English course, but using English is my duty, not your duty, not students' duty. So students can ask questions in Korean. Okay? So, 예, 한국어로 질문을 해도 됩니다. 한국어로. 예, 뭐 그러면 제가 뭐 한국어로 써도 되는 질문에 대해서는 한국어로 제가 대답을 해줄 수 있고요. 예, 예 그렇게 하면 됩니다. 그러니까 뭐 질문하는 거를 뭐 두려워하지 마시고 뭐 한국어로 쓰든 뭐 영어로 쓰든 뭐 잘 뭐 질문하시면은 되겠습니다. 오케이. In this course, I will use the computer organization and design written by David Patterson and John Hennessy as a textbook. Actually, there are three different versions of this book, MIPS version, ARM version, and RISC-V version. And then in this course, I will use the RISC-V version. So actually, this MIPS ARM RISC-V is the RISC. So what is the RISC? R-I-S-C. So what is the RISC? RISC is Reduced Instruction Set Computer. And then some opposite term is the CISC. CISC is the Complex Instruction Set Computer. So actually the x86 CPUs made by Intel or AMD as the is CISC, yeah, Complex Instruction Set Computer. But the ARM CPUs, the most of the application processor embedded in smartphone has the ARM architecture. ARM is the RISC. Reduced instruction set architecture. So what is different? Reduced instruction set architecture has the simpler form of instructions. And on the other hand, CISC is complex instruction, so has the more complex instruction forms. So which is the better? Which is better? We cannot say which is better, but for the student it is easy to understand the RISC better because it's a RISC has the simpler form. So in this course we will learn about the RISC-V instruction set architecture. Actually, so this textbook covers some part of RISC-V ISA instruction set architecture. So actually the RISC-V instruction set architecture is the open source architecture. ARM is not open source, so if a company want to use the ARM processor or ARM instructions, then they need to pay license fee to the ARM company. But RISC-V is the open source architecture. So there's no license fee to use the RISC-V instruction set architecture. So recently, the industry or academia have a very some high interest in the this RISC-V instruction set architecture. So that's why I select the RISC-V edition for this course. Okay. And then, so for the course material, I will use the lecture slides, and then I will post the lecture slide on the Blackboard or Piazza. Then for this course, I plan to use the architecture simulator for RISC-V. So I plan to provide some project to implement the RISC-V processor using System Verilog. Okay. So this is the photo of David Patterson and John Hennessy. Actually, they are the most famous computer architect. Actually, they are very famous. Who is David Patterson? I can use this. He's Hennessy and he's David Patterson. And they designed the first RISC processor concept with their graduate student at UC Berkeley and Stanford. And then, can you see that this textbook? this textbook is not computer organization design. This textbook is also the famous book in the computer architecture field. It's a computer architecture of quantitative approach. It's a very famous book. Actually, the advanced level learns from this book. And then the undergraduate level computer architecture, students learn with the computer organization and design. It's a very famous book. And then I also learned from this book. This book. Okay. See, this is the recent photo of the David Patterson and John Hennessy. They received the Turing Award in 2018. And then Turing Award is the most prominent award in computer science field. So it's called the Nobel Prize in Computer Science or Computer Engineering. And Turing Award recipient provide lecture. This lecture is called the Turing Lecture. And then you can find the Turing Lecture presented during ISCA 2018 here. So I recommend you to watch this Turing lecture. And then in this lecture, they explain about the history of RISC processor, and then some current issues in the computer processor. And then they mentioned the RISC-V processor and then domain-specific architecture. It's some current issues in the computer processors. So if you watch this Turing lecture, then you can understand the history of RISC type processor, also some history of the computer processor and the computer systems. Okay, I strongly recommend you to watch this video. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, these are the prerequisites of this course. This is some recommendation. Okay, I believe most of computer engineering students took digital logic design course before this computer architecture course. It's a course number is the COSE 211. And then also students know about the need to know about the basic knowledge on programming language, especially C, not Python. So I believe most of the students prefer Python because Python is easy to learn, but for some system programming or for understanding some computer architecture, C is better because the operating system or system applications are written in C or C++. So, but in this course, we will cover just a small part of the C. So you don't need to understand the whole scope of the C. You don't need to. So we will just cover the small part of very basic of C in this course, okay? So don't worry about some your programming skill. And then about me. So my name is Geun-jae Koo, and Geun-jae in Korean. And then my office is at Ojong Jeongbogan 403. And then I set the office hours from 1:30 to 3:30 Monday. And then this is my email address. Okay. And then this is my webpage. So if you are interested, then you can visit my webpage, and then you can see my some research interest or research areas. So my research area is generally computer architecture. And then this is my some detailed research topics like GPU architecture, memory and storage systems, and embedded systems, accelerators, and the FPGA. So this is my research area. Okay. And then if you are interested in the, some undergraduate researcher position, then you can contact me. Yeah. 뭐, 사실 이게 2학년 과목이라서 학부 연구생 좀 어려울 수도 있긴 한데요. 학부 연구생 그래도 혹시 뭐 관심이 있다고 하면은 뭐 저한테 연락을 해도 됩니다. 오케이, okay. I will use the blackboard and Piazza as the course management tool. So actually, I need to use KU Blackboard, yeah, Korea University Blackboard, and then I will use Blackboard for announcement and posting assignment and lecture slide. Also, you can submit your homework assignment and quiz answers on the blackboard. Okay. And then I will use Piazza for the discussion platform. So this is the address of the Piazza for this course. It's piazza.com, korea.h.kr, fall2020, and then COSC 222. This is the Piazza address, and then you can sign up Piazza with the access code. It's a password like COD RISC-V, COD computer organization and design RISC-V. Okay. And then please join as a student, not instructor or TA. Please join as a student. And then this Piazza is the class management and discussion tool. So I know that this Blackboard also provides the discussion board, but this discussion board is not easy to use. The interface is not good on the Blackboard. Actually, the Blackboard provides many functions, but problem is that Blackboard, the functions in the Blackboard is not easy to use. So that's why many universities use Piazza for the discussion platform, course management platforms. So actually the universities in United States used Piazza for the class management tool or discussion tool. So in the Piazza, anyone can post questions and answers. Also, you can download the mobile app of Piazza in the Google Play or Apple App Store. So if you post your question on the Piazza, then TAs or I will answer as soon as possible. So this is the best way to get answer from me or TAs. Also, any student can answer, any student can post answers for the questions on Piazza. Okay, this is the some grading policy, but this policy is not fixed. So I plan to have two exams, midterm and final exams. And then I plan to give four assignments after every chapter. So, and then I set the attendance point, and then this attendance point is determined by the some pop quiz score or some the activity in the Piazza, so online discussion. But normally, so this attendance score is determined by the pop quiz scores. Okay. Exam. I plan the on-site exam, but it depends on the COVID-19 situation. The situation is not good recently. So, it's not easy to do. So actually, the on-site exam is the this default exam. What's that? University recommend the on-site exams. So on-site exam is better than online exams. But it depends on the COVID-19 situation. So I hope this pandemic will end quickly. But as you know, the current situation is not easy, it's not good. And then the exams is the closed book exam, and then no electric device are allowed, and except basic calculator, just basic calculator. And then any cheating may result in F in this course, so please be honest. And then you can answer in Korean or English. As I said, using English is my duty, not your duty. So you can use Korean, okay? Okay, this is, it's a 16 weeks. Oh, I did not fix it. It's a 16 week schedule, class schedule, and you can read this schedule here and here, and then classes will be canceled for the Chuseok holiday. It's on September 3, it's Wednesday. Okay. Do you have any questions? It's the end of the syllabus. Okay, there is no question. Okay, and then now I will go on to I will go to chapter one of the discourse. Yeah, it's a chapter one of this course is the computer abstractions and technology. This is the introductory chapter, so I will briefly explain about these topics in the first two class, during the first two classes. Okay. So let us remind the object of this course, and the object of this course is exploring computer system architecture at an abstract level. So that means we will learn about computer systems. Then what does computer system means? So this figure shows a first generation personal computer designed by IBM. So very huge. And then you can find the green letters on the monitor. It's a very old computer. And then after some years, Apple made a fancier computer. It's an Apple III computer. So it looks fancier than the first generation computer developed by IBM. And then the same company made very beautiful computer, like Apple, so it's an Apple computer. So these are the typical figures of a computer system. So you can think that, oh, this is the typical computers. So do you agree with me? Where is the chatting window? I don't know. Oh, yes. This is the very old computer, actually. So then recently, we are using laptop, so notebook, laptop computers, or a smartphone. So, so actually, I think the figures are very different. Okay. Sometimes Apple made a very weird looking computers. Like this is the MacBook Pro. It looks like a cylinder. So, 원통형이죠, cylinder. And then also Apple made this MacBook Pro computer, new MacBook Pro computer. And then it looks like cheese grinder. This one. It looks like a cheese grinder. But I think this is a weird looking, but I believe most of computer engineering students wants to buy these computers if affordable. Yeah. This, we know Apple computers are very expensive for, and normally Apple computers are not affordable to buy for students. Okay, by the way, most of us always use computer systems. Most of the cellular phones are smartphone nowadays, and that means every smartphone has general purpose computer processors, or these general purpose processors are called CPU, Central Processing Unit. So actually, every smartphone has general purpose processors. So smartphone is a kind of computer systems, right? That is because the smartphones equip processors. And then these processors can run general purpose applications. So the general purpose application means that every type of applications and different types of application like a game, office applications, web browser, some operating system. These are the different types of applications. smartphone can run different types of applications. So smartphones are computer systems. And how about the smartwatch? And how about the smart speakers? They have also general purpose processors like a CPU. So they are also computer systems. Okay. And then recently we are facing the different types of computer systems called the domain-specific processors. So actually, in the Turing lecture, I mentioned the domain-specific processors. So in the Turing lecture, the Patterson and Hennessy mentioned the domain-specific processor. This is some recent topic in the computer architecture field. And then this type of a computer processor cannot run general purpose applications. On the other hand, these type of processors accelerate the execution of specific domain applications. So not general purpose application. So for example, this is the Google TensorFlow unit called the TPU. And then this TensorFlow unit accelerate the performance of neural networking or machine learning applications. Other application, this processor is not helpful. But for the neural networking application, this processor can improve the performance of a neural networking application very efficiently. And then another type of domain-specific processor is the FPGA-based acceleration card. And then this acceleration card is made by Intel. And then there is the FPGA inside of this acceleration card. And then you can implement any accelerators inside of this acceleration card. And what is this? GPU. GPU is the graphics processing unit. And then we buy GPU for better gaming environment, for better gaming performance. But recently, GPUs are used for which application? Machine learning applications. So GPUs are deployed in the high performance server systems, and then GPUs are used for training or analyzing some machine learning applications. And then GPUs are very expensive, okay? These are the new types of computer systems. Okay, computer systems also include gigantic infrastructure for bunch of operations. And then, so we are all familiar with cloud computing and data center. These are gigantic computers. So you can think that, oh, these are the some group of computers, but we can think that this data center is the one computer system. So this is the photo of a Google data center. And then you can find that many computers and many servers are connected each other with this network cable. You can find the bunch of network cables here. So this is, what is this? This photo looks like a factory. But what is this? This is the some water pipe these are the water pipes for cooling down the computer systems. So cooling is very important issue in the data center or cloud computer system, cloud infrastructure. So we can say that this data center and the infrastructures are also computer systems. The size of this computer system is very huge. The size is the multiples of a soccer stadium. So it's very huge computer systems. So in conclusion, computer systems include all systems or processors that can run programs or general purpose programs or domain specific programs. So if a certain system can run programs, then that is the computer system. And then nowadays, most of electric devices run programs. Like, so you can find the refrigerator here, you can find the television here. Also, refrigerator or television has processors, embedded processors. So they are kind of computer systems. So we can say that these all devices, smartphone, Raspberry Pi, server, laptop, smart speaker, TV, and the washing machines are all computer systems. So computer architecture studies hardware of computer systems and software for learning computer systems. So computer architecture is a very important research for understanding computer systems. And computer architecture research focuses on better computer system. So what is the better computer system? High performance and low cost. That is the basic of engineering. High performance, high gain with lower cost, low investment. Okay. Okay, we learn about the different types of computer systems. So personal computers, so you are using personal computers such as desktop computers or laptop computers. So these personal computers is the general purpose computers. And that means that this computer can run variety of software, okay? And then this computer has the balanced cost and performance, because this is the personal use. And how about the server computers like this one? Server computers are network-based. So that means that server systems are connected to network, like an internet. And then many users connected to the server systems server computers provide some services such as the some cloud services such as Gmail, Google Search, or Naver Search. So these are the services provided by server computers, cloud. So what is required? The performance should be very high because many users are using these server computers concurrently, simultaneously. So the server computers require high capacity and high performance and then high reliability. What is the reliability? So stable operation. And then supercomputers. So I believe, where is the supercomputer in Korea? Right. 기상청 supercomputer 가지고 있죠. 요새 뭐 욕을 많이 얻어먹어서 supercomputer로 게임하는 거 아니냐 뭐 그런 말을 듣고 있긴 한데, 네, 맞습니다. So supercomputer is the high-end. Actually high-end computer system. And then these supercomputers are used for scientific or some engineering calculation. Also, these supercomputers are used for forecasting weather, because the forecasting weather requires a very extensive scientific calculation. So these supercomputers has the highest capability, and performance is the very high. And then many computing nodes are connected to each other to calculate some very extensive scientific applications. But this in the market, this supercomputer really occupied a small fraction of the computer market, because these supercomputers are used by only some government agency, and then some very small number of laboratory. 사실 뭐 정부 차원의 연구소나 뭐 기상청 빼고는 슈퍼컴퓨터를 사용하기가 힘들죠. 워낙 비싸서. 예. And embedded computers. So these embedded computers is the embedded computer is that this embedded computer is the some processors embedded in the consumer electric devices. So, for example, the embedded processor is embedded in the television or refrigerator or washing machines. So these are the some consumer electric devices. It means that this device has some specific purpose. And then this embedded computer is actually the small processors embedded in the specific devices. So for these embedded computers, we need to keep some restrictions for the devices, like a power, performance, or cost restrictions. Okay. Oh. So people diving in the study of computer architecture, I will give several questions related to computer architecture. So now you are looking at the different type of processors, Intel Pentium 4 1 point, and then this is the ARM processor used in Raspberry Pi version 3B. And then the left side processor is Intel Pentium 4. And then this processor is working at 1.3 gigahertz of system clock frequency. Now how about the Raspberry Pi? This ARM processor has the 1.2 gigahertz system clocks. Then which processor is better? So which processor is better? Intel Pentium 4 or this ARM processor in Raspberry Pi? Pentium? So actually the most of people think that if the clock frequency is higher, then the performance is also higher. But it's not always true in the computer processors. So if we learn about the computer system in this course, then you can answer after taking this course, okay? About this one, the left side processor is Intel Xeon processor, and then right side processor is the Intel i7. So which processor is better? And then which processor is more expensive? Oh, there is the right answer. Depends on purpose. So which processor is more expensive? So normally Intel Xeon is more expensive because Xeon is used for server computers. But which processor is better? So we don't know, because for the single thread, the i7 can be better. The performance of i7 can be better, but why Intel Xeon is more expensive? Because server computers need to provide high capacity. That means more cores and high performance and reliability. The performance of Xeon and i7 can be similar. Well, and then even the clock frequency. The clock frequency of Intel Xeon can be lower than the Intel i7. But Intel Xeon is designed for server computers. So and then server computers need to provide high capacity, high performance, and high reliability. So normally Intel Xeon is more expensive than Intel i7 because Intel i7 is designed for desktop computers. Which is better? Depends on the ports. That's why. Okay, how about this? Intel Xeon and then NVIDIA, Tesla. Tesla, NVIDIA, Tesla is GPU. Which is better? Actually, those are different types of processor. Intel Xeon is CPU, and then NVIDIA Tesla is GPU. And then how many cores, how many processors are included in this CPU chip or GPU chip? Intel Xeon include about 16 to 28 cores included in the Intel Xeon CPU, single CPU. And then Tesla, NVIDIA GPU, includes hundreds to thousand cores in single chip. Which is better? So if we only see the number of cores, then NVIDIA Tesla may be better. But you know, that's not true. So if you learn about the computer architecture, then you can answer after taking this course. You need to answer after taking this course. Okay? Actually, I said that the purpose of computer architecture research is to increase the performance of a computer system. And then these other factors that decide the performance of a computer system. So actually, the computer system runs the software. That means that the performance of software and hardware are both critical. So this is the better hardware, but software is very bad. Then the overall performance may be very low. So in order to increase the performance of a computer system, we need to improve the performance of both software and hardware. Okay, let's see the, some factors that decides the performance of computer systems algorithm. That is the software part, right? So in order to increase the performance of software performance, we need to use better algorithm. That's true. Algorithm decides the performance of software, and then also this algorithm determines the what? Number of operations executed in computer systems. How about the programming language like Python and C? Which is better? What is different? Python and C. That's right. So normally, if you write programs, oh, okay, That's true. So if you write the program using C, then the program after compilation, the program by written in C will be better, because Python is the interpreter language, and then C is the compiled language. Okay. 좋은 답변인데요. C는 컴퓨터가 빠르고 파이썬은 사람이 빠르고요. 아주 좋은 답변입니다. Okay, so programming language also decide the performance of a software. Also compiler option decides the performance of a software. You will learn why this compiler option determines the performance of a software. Also, architecture. This architecture means the instruction set architecture. So these are also determines the performance of a computer system. And then hardware, processor and memory system. These are the hardware of a computer system. Hardware also determines the performance of a computer system. And then I/O, input and output. So I/O includes the networking or some peripherals of the computer system, like input devices or output devices. So these are the all factors that it decides the performance of a computer system. So in order to improve the performance of a computer system, we need to consider these all factors. Okay. So this is conclusion. Why need to learn computer architecture? So I believe the students select this course because this course is the mandatory course in computer engineering, right? So 어쩔 수 없이 뭐 선택을 한 그런 학생들도 많이 있을 거라 생각합니다. 예. This is the mandatory course in the computer science and engineering. So that's why you are taking this course. But you need to set the motivation for this course. So why do you need this course, computer architecture? So taking this computer architecture course is a basic step to understand computer system hardware, and then interface between computer hardware and software. And then this computer architecture research is essential for building better computer systems. I said that the better computer system means the high performance and low cost computer systems. And so, and then some students may think that this computer architecture is only required for computer hardware engineer, but that's not true. And then recently, the front hardware is being developed. So, and then especially for GPU or domain-specific processors, the software engineer need to understand how this processor work with the specific domain application. So, also if you understand how the computer hardware work, then you can build a better software. Better software means that higher performance or low cost also. So this complicated course is the essential course in computer engineering and computer science field. That's why this course is the mandatory course in the computer engineering department. Right? Yeah. So please study hard. And yeah, for some students, this course may be difficult because this is the first architecture course and then first computer system course. But we'll feel difficult and study hard. And if you have any questions, post your questions on the PR chat. And then I will give, I promise I will give the answer as soon as possible. 그래서 뭐 결론은 열심히 공부하세요 라는 겁니다. 예, 그래서 예, 중요한 학문이고요. 사실 컴퓨터 시스템을 이해를 하고 컴퓨터 하드웨어를 이해를 하는데 중요한 학문이기 때문에 열심히 공부하세요. Yeah, so conclusion is study hard for this course. So I will stop here. Do you have any questions? Okay. 수고 많으셨습니다. 예. 뭐 처음 줌인데. 예. 뭐 잘 흘러간 것 같고요. 예. 수고 많았습니다. So I will stop here and then see you at the in the next class, okay? And then this Zoom is also recorded and I will post this recorded video on the YouTube. So you can watch this video later, okay? Bye, see you later.